Very good morning to all of you. I am Dr. Shashi Gurun and welcome to online learning program in C++. Today the topic is switch control statement in C++. So after going through this video presentation, you will be able to define a switch control statement. You will be know the syntax of this switch control statement, and in the end you will be able to make a program using switch control statement in C++. So let's start with the topic. Now, what is a switch control statement? Switch control statement are those statement which is used when there are multiple conditions, and when any condition is satisfied, then particular set of the instruction are executed. It is also a multi-way branching statement. It is an alternative to if-else if statement. In if-else if statement, we also define multiple conditions, and when any condition is satisfied, then particular block of code is executed. So instead of if-else if, you can also use switch control statement. In switch control statement, it tests the value of variable and compare it with each cases. We will discuss what is the cases in switch control statement in the program. In switch control statement, there are two keywords which are optional, that is break and default. Now let us understand the syntax of the switch control statement. So you can see that this is a switch keyword and this is an expression. Here there can be value or there can be variable. That is switch A. Within the switch control statement, there are case. This is a case, and case is a keyword, and this is a case label. Here there should be constant expression. When this value of the variable matches with any constant expression, then that particular case block of code is executed. If it is matching with this, then this will execute. If it is matching with this, then this statement will be executed. If there is it is not matching with any cases, then the default section will be executed. For example, in if else if, when any condition is checked, if this condition is not satisfied, then we check the another condition. Again, if this condition is not satisfied, then we check also another if condition. If all these conditions are not satisfied, then the else part is executed. So similarly, in switch control statement, it tests the value against the case label. In switch control statement, the break and default keywords are used. When a break statement is executed, the switch terminates and the flow of control jumps to the next line following the switch statement. It means that you can see that this is a syntax of the switch. So after this control, after this break statement is encountered, the control will jump at the end of the switch body. So whatever you have written after that, that will execute. If there is no breaks, then the flow of control will continue with the next case until a break is reached. It means that if there is no break, then it will execute this statement. If again there is no break, then it will execute all the cases till the break is encountered. As and when the break statement is encountered, it will immediately comes out of the switch body and the control will jump to this line. In switch control statement, the default keyword is executed if no case constant value is equal to the value of expression If no condition is matching, then the default statement will be executed. In if else if, any condition is not matching, then the else part will be executed. In default section, there is no need of break, and default is used at the end of the switch body. Now here I am going to make a program using switch control statement. First of all, we have to include the header file, that is iostream. After that, using namespace std, then there will be main function, that is int main. And here I will declare a variable int a. Now the value will be entered by the user. Enter any number, and it will be stored in a variable. Now here I can use the switch control statement, that is a, and we'll check case 1 and then cout Monday and then break. Here the value will be entered by the user. If it is 1, then it will say that Monday. If it is 2, then it is Tuesday. Then case 2, cout Tuesday, then break. Then case 3, cout Wednesday, then break. Case 4, cout Thursday, then break. Case 5, cout Friday, then break. Case 6, cout Saturday, break. Case 7, cout Sunday, break. Else, in if else if we use else, but in switch we use default, then cout invalid number, then switch body close, then return 0, then curly braces. So this is a simple program of the switch control statement. So when the user will enter the value after getting this message, suppose he has entered 2. Now the A value is 2. Now it will match with this case label. Now it is not matching, so it will move to this. Now it is matching, so it will display the message cout Tuesday, that is Tuesday. And there is a break, then it will immediately come outside this switch control body. So the control flow will directly come here. It will not execute all these cases. But suppose if there is no break, then it will execute this line and then this line. And then there is a break, then it will come outside this body. If again there is no break, then it will execute this and this, and here again it will come outside this body. If there is no break in the switch control body, then it will execute this and even the default statement. Now you can also use character in switch control statement. For that, again you have to include iostream header file, then using namespace std, then in the int main function I am declaring a character variable, that is char ch. Now the value will be entered by the user. Enter any character. If suppose I have written that if the user enter A, then it should print true. If the user enter B, then it should print false. Suppose this is an example. So switch ch. Case A. It should be within single quotation. If it is integer, then it should not be within single quotation as discussed in previous program. But here it is a character, so we have to include in single quotation. Then cout. For A, I am writing true. And then break. Suppose this is a code word. Then case B, cout, false. And then break. In default, cout in valid. This is a bracket for the switch. Then return 0 and then curly braces. Suppose this is a program that is a code word. If the value of character is A, then it is true. If the value of character is B, then it is false. If there is any other value, that is C, D, then it is invalid. So when the user enter A, then it will show the value true on the output screen. If the value entered by the user is B, then it will show the message false. If C is entered, then it will show the message invalid. Now I am going to implement this switch control statement in code block software. So let's see in the code block software. Now this is a code block software. Here I have already written switch control statement program. So you can see that in switch control statement there are many cases, case 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So here when you enter any number, then it will check with all these cases constant expression, that is 1, 2, and then it will show you the output. For example, here I am entering the number 7, that is, it is Sunday. If I enter the number more than 7, then it will show invalid. That is 8, invalid. You can also write here multiple line of code, that is Monday, on Monday. If I enter 1, so it is printing both message Monday, on Monday. Now if I remove the break statement to see the output. Suppose in 6 there is a break statement. So when you run this program, I am entering the value 1 for Monday. So it will show all the value of the cases, that is Monday, on Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday. In Saturday, there is a break statement, that is this. If you remove this, then it will print all the messages. You can see 1, so it is printing all the messages. That's why we use break statement. You can also remove the default. Want to run, then in that case, if the condition is more than 8, so it will not print any message. So that's why it is optional. So today in this video lecture, I hope you have understood the concept of switch control statement. Switch control statement is used when there is a multiple condition. So that's why it is also known as multi-way decision making control statement. We have also implemented this switch control statement in code block software. So you make this program, run this program and see the output. Thank you.